you might think lice are not so nice.
This is pretty cool, isn't it? I love seeing these guys. They're so amazing to watch. And they're so fast, it's really hard to keep up with them.
But they're now helping scientists scratch the surface of some big scientific mysteries.
People have been studying human migration patterns for decades, many decades, based on fossil evidence and molecular data like DNA sequences. But more recently, we're also looking at the parasites that live on humans.
This is a louse that's just emerging from that egg casing. It's really remarkable.
With help from the National Science Foundation, mammologist David Reed studies human migration at the Florida Museum of Natural History. He collects lice DNA from around the world to trace the movement and development of human populations after the first Homo sapiens left Africa about 100,000 years ago.
There are two different types of lice that occur in the New World. Did one come with Europeans and one with the first peoples? And if we can find out from the lice when people got to the New World, we can use that information to trace their routes.
For example, the lice could help determine what group of people started this great migration from Asia. Do the lice on humans in North America now have DNA more similar to lice in Mongolia or Siberia?
We see that for some reason the parasites are telling us something different about their shared evolutionary history than what we've learned already from their hosts.
Reed had a rare opportunity to go back in time and learn what lice have to tell about humans in pre-Columbian South America.
A colleague of ours had some Peruvian mummies that were rapidly mummified about 1,000 years ago, and these mummy individuals still had head lice, and we were able to sequence DNA from those ancient mummy lice.
Their evolutionary strengths may be good for research, but can be frustrating for parents and school kids dealing with an infestation.
It's become such an epidemic problem because populations of lice are resistant to the shampoos.
Who would think these tiny creatures could hold so many clues to the mystery of human migration? Reed is just itching to learn more. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.